Hi everyone! Finally, Epic released the Game Animation Sample project that includes a very advanced configuration to animate a character using the motion matching system with more than 500 high-resolution animations. Today we are going to see how to get the sample project, see the motion matching in action, and finally how to use our custom Metahumans with this great suite of controls and animations. First of all, you need to have the Unreal Engine 5.4 or later installed, otherwise the motion matching won't be available. Now, open the Epic Launcher, and here you can get the project either by searching the marketplace for game animation and find the game animation sample, or by going in the Samples tab, where you can find the project among the others already available. Select it and click Create Project. A download will start, and as of June 2024, the size is about 5 gigabytes, but in the future, this will probably change. When the download is over and the project has been created, you can open it. The first time it will take a while because of shaders compilation. When the project is open, wait until you can see the Unreal logo on the ground clearly, because on the first run, the project is still being set up by the engine. Okay. Let's play the main level right away. There are several buttons on the ground. They are activated when the player steps on them, overlapping their trigger volume. The three buttons on the back are just used to change the color of the level, and as you can see, the change is immediate. Then we have the main group of buttons. The green one shows a README describing the project and letting us know that this is an evolving project. In fact, Epic plans to update it in the future by adding new mechanics and refinements, and this is a very good thing for us. The View Controls button shows a window that illustrates the character and camera controls. As of today, we can't sprint or crouch, but with the release of version 5.5, Epic will release an update of the project where these controls will be available. Note that you can also use a controller instead of mouse and keyboard to control your character. Next up, we have the game animation widget, and when hitting it, the widget shows up and it contains useful settings, especially for debugging and inspecting the system, like collisions, bones, player trajectory, and so on. In the widget, we can also set the FPS limits in order to test the movements at different frame rates. There's a timescale option too. It lets us slow down or speed up time, and that's useful in order to observe the evolution of the character animations and their blending. Here you can see me running around in different directions, and it's clearly visible how well the motion matching is working and the quality of the animation being played. Let's try to trigger the traversal mechanics to see how the animation will look when trying to jump over or climb an obstacle. I find it almost perfect, and it works really, really smoothly, and I think that this is AAA quality, guys, and getting all of this for free is really impressive. Don't forget that getting this level of quality and complexity would otherwise require us to spend tons of money. But what if we want to use another character? The game animation widget is already set up to allow us to switch the main character, letting us choose between several pre-made ones. These are useful as a reference and to quickly test different meshes. And now we are going to see how to use a custom Metahuman instead. I'm going to use the Metahuman I've created in another video using my pictures. You can see how to create one by checking out the video I've posted some time ago. The link is in the description. Let's open the Add menu in the top bar and open Quixel Bridge from there. Head over to Metahumans and select My Metahumans to get a list of the Metahumans you created in Metahuman Creator. If you don't have one or don't want to create it right now, you can always choose one from the presets. When you have selected the desired Metahuman, choose the quality of it and click the download button. It may require a variable amount of time, but when it's done, you should see a green check mark instead of the download button, like this. Then simply click Add to add it to your project. You will find a new subfolder inside the Metahumans folder containing all the assets related to your Metahuman. Now, let's open the Blueprints folder and then the Retargeted Characters folder. Here we need to create a copy of the blueprint called CBP Sandbox Character Metahuman Kellan. So right click on it and select duplicate and call it whatever you want. Something like CBP underscore followed by the name of your character could be a good choice. Open the duplicated blueprint and in the components select the body and all its children and delete them. Delete also the load sync component. Leave this blueprint open and open also your custom Metahuman blueprint. Select the body component and all its children, include also the load sync in the selection, and right-click and click copy. Go back to the duplicated blueprint, right-click in the components window and select paste. You should see now your Metahuman mesh appearing in the viewport. Move the body to align it with the capsule component and be sure also to rotate it, so that the head looks in the same direction of the arrow. We also need to assign an animation class to it, so click the drop down in the details panel and select ABP generic retarget. To let the retargeting process run correctly, we need to let the animation blueprint know about this new body, and we'll do that by using a special tag. In the details panel, search for tags and add one component tag and name it as you see on the screen. Now head over to the construction script because we have to fix something here. And we can see that there are three enable master pose function nodes that have the skeletal mesh components input missing. We need to connect the torso, legs, and feet components of our Metahuman to these inputs. And you can do so just by dragging the components over the inputs. Finally, open the enable master pose function and do the same for the set leader pose component, but this time with the body component. Okay, the construction script is fine now, but we need one more step here because we need to select the body and make it a child of the mesh component. And be sure to do this because it's very important. Now you should see the idle animation playing correctly in the viewport. Fine, now let's make our character selectable from the game animation widget. And don't worry, this is a really, really easy step. Navigate to the widget folder and open the widget. Select one of the character override boxes, copy it and then paste. Another box will appear, and inside its details panel, we just need to set the object property to our CBP blueprint. You should see the icon change accordingly. Compile and save the blueprint, then go back to the editor and play the level. So, congratulations! Now if you open the game animation widget, you can select your own Metahuman and use it in the level. So, that's all guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you did, please subscribe to the channel, and if you want to take your support to the next level, be sure to check out my Patreon page in the video description. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Until then, keep on creating, and cheers!